Yo, what is going on, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Viz, and welcome today to the latest in series that we are introducing on our channel, and it has to do with fantasy football. And no, this is not fantasy American football. This is fantasy actual football, like the European football or South American football or Latin American, whatever. You guys know what I'm saying. Anyway, what this series is supposed to be, it's kind of a learning process for me and Scott. And we're also going to kind of give our opinions on what we think, like the players that you should be playing, and show the mistakes that we make, and hopefully that we can learn from those mistakes, and maybe you can learn from those mistakes as well. So, obviously the BPL kicked off last weekend, and I'm going to show you guys the team that I started with last week. Now, keep in mind, neither of us have ever played any type of online fantasy football before. And so this is the team that I ended up last week. Mertesacker, Williams, Clichy, and company in the defense with Mignolet in goal. Johnson, Santi, Walcott, Tadopt in the midfield, and then Lukaku and Aguero up top. Now you can see I have a decent bench as well. But, so okay, let me summarize how this team played last week. Obviously, you can see here we had Aguero and Mignolet in the Dream Team. I guess we can take a look at that real quick. Dream Team scored a total of 146 points. Now, you can see several Chelsea players there, but you also have to keep in mind that they played two games this week. So they're going to have more points than they usually would have. And I named Santi as my captain and put him in my team, assuming that he would be a no-brainer start for Wenger. And then I was watching last weekend's game, and I was absolutely stunned to see that Santi did not start for Arsenal. And he only got put in like an hour into the game, which obviously is really going to hurt his overall point total. And I had also named him my captain, and so he got double points on 0 points, so that was a whopping 0 points that Santi got me, which was a little frustrating because I know that Santi is apparently usually one of the highest average scorers per week in fantasy football. And the same was with Walcott, but we just really struggled on the offensive side of the ball and just couldn't get much done. And so having this many Arsenal players in your squad, it's a 50-50, because if you have a lot of players from one team, if they have a really great week, then chances are your team, your fantasy team, is going to have a really great week. But same goes with the opposite. If you don't have such a good week with these three Arsenal players, then chances are, well, your fantasy team also isn't going to have the best week. And so I kind of went out on a limb picking up these three Arsenal players, and you can also see three Manchester City players, and the Arsenal idea did not work out nearly as well for me as the Manchester City idea did. Arsenal played Aston Villa, and I'm sure a lot of you guys know that we lost 3-1 at home to Aston Villa on two penalties. There were two penalties that they scored against us, which was pretty frustrating. But my Manchester City players played a lot better for me. You can see here that both Clichy and company got me 6 points. They did not let in any goals, and they also played the entire... Actually, no, company did not play the entire game because he went off with a groin injury. And as you can see here, he has a little yellow icon, meaning that he has a groin injury, and that he also only has a 50% chance of playing this weekend. So... actually, I'm going to talk about my two strikers really quick. I'm going to keep Aguero in my squad for this week, but I actually ended up taking out Lukaku, and that's going to kind of segue me into what team I am playing for this upcoming weekend. Now, you get one free transfer, and I was messing around with the transfers last night, and I didn't know that you get one free transfer, and then you get like subtracted points for every transfer after that. And so what I did was I took out Lukaku, I got him out of the squad, and I put in Dzeko in place of Lukaku. Now, the reason that I did that was, one, Lukaku through two games had only scored me 2 points, and two, I picked up Dzeko because they are playing this weekend Cardiff City, and they are a recently promoted team to the BPL, and I know that if they just got recently promoted to the BPL, chances are they are not going to have as strong of a defense as a current BPL squad. So if I put in two forwards from Manchester City, chances are they're going to be able to rack me up some pretty solid points, especially if Aguero can put on the kind of show that he had last week. Now, the second change that I made to the squad was I put Kompany in the bench because I want to keep Kompany just because he's such an absolutely solid defender for Manchester City. But what I did was I got rid of Clichy. And when I got rid of Clichy, I decided to put in Dawson. And the reason I put in Dawson was because this weekend they are playing Swansea City. Last weekend, Swansea City actually scored one goal against Manchester City. I'm trying to remember why in the world I got rid of Clichy and put in Dawson. Oh, okay. So Dawson was actually a cheaper player than Clichy, but he's still a really solid defender. So that leaves me 1.5 million. And actually, Dzeko was cheaper than Lukaku. So that leaves me 1.5 million. To spend hopefully somewhere later down the road, strengthening I'm probably going to spend the money strengthening my midfield because I'm not entirely comfortable with Trapped and Johnson here. Although I am very comfortable with Santi and Walcott, I'm pretty confident that they're going to be able to snag me some goals, goals and points as well, but not so much with Johnson and Trapped. So that was kind of my thinking behind the squad that I put together for this week. I'm probably going to wait until next week to transfer out one of these midfielders so I can use that free transfer because I'm already a few points in the hole for this week because I made two transfers. I named Santi my captain just because I know he's one of the highest average scoring players in fantasy football, like I said earlier. So I gave him the captain's armband last week. He didn't get any points, unfortunately, but I think that he'll be starting this week, actually, because Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain is out now for at least a couple months with a knee injury, I believe. And so, actually, 2 days ago, Arsenal played their one of the qualification games for a pool play spot, I believe it is, for the Champions League, and Santi started in place of Oxlade-Chamberlain, so I'm pretty confident that Santi will be starting this weekend, so I am confident in giving him the captain's armband. Now, actually, I'm thinking about it now, and Aguero and Dzeko are going to be playing not as tough of a defense as Arsenal are playing, because Arsenal are playing Fulham, which, I mean, they're not the greatest BPL team, no offense to any Fulham fans out there, but now that I think about it, I think I'm going to give the captain's armband to Aguero just because they are playing not as strong of a defense. Now, who are Swansea playing this weekend? Oh, Tottenham. Okay. That makes me a little worried with my defense here because Davies and Williams both play for Swansea City. And now I'm thinking that I should maybe risk spending a few more points and picking up a better defender or a defender that's playing for a different team because some of you guys might know Tottenham played today and they went 5-0 against whoever this squad is. I'm not sure who they played. And I don't know why they played. This might have been also some sort of Champions League game. I'm not sure. But this is taking forever to pull up here. Okay, yeah. Tottenham scored 5 goals against Dinamo Tbilisi, and they did that all without the help of Bale. Soldado scored a couple, and man, okay, he didn't even play an entire game, so that worries me a little bit. Okay, let's see. What kind of options do I have in the transfer market in terms of defenders? Because I have 1.5 mil to spend on top of whatever Davies and Williams. Okay, so they were both 1.5 or 5, and then I could put 1.5 on top of that. So I could spend 6.5 on a defender. What kind of players could I get? Okay, I'm not gonna get Ivanovic. I would get him if they hadn't already played out their two games. This is a little difficult. Now, wait, why did that reset like that? Okay. Now there are a lot of players in here that I'm not entirely familiar with. So I might hold off on that this week and see how this defense treats me. I did get rid of Clichy, but now that I'm thinking about. Oh, okay, now I remember. The reason I got rid of Clichy is because I can't have four defenders or four players total from Manchester City. But yeah, all right, I'm going to think about that a little bit more and then I might update you guys on that. But anyway, I've been sort of all over the place in this commentary and I apologize for that. This is my first attempt at a commentary like this, talking about the Fantasy Premier League. Yeah, so this is the team that I'm going to end up with this week for this week. I kind of talked about my decision making in some of the players that I'm starting and not starting. But I would really love to hear you guys' feedback on what you guys think about this series, if this is something you guys would like to see us continue giving you tips and whatnot, giving our insight in what players should and should not be playing. This is a series that's going to be weekly for as long as the BPL is in season. And normally we're going to be doing this with both Scott and I. Unfortunately, he could not join me tonight. He had some other things that he had to take care of. But this commentary is also kind of dragging on here. But I really appreciate you guys watching. If you do enjoy this, leave us a like so that we know that you're enjoying it, or drop a comment or something like that. And if you dislike it, well, then I don't know. Do whatever you feel is appropriate. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, my name is Viz. Peace out. Take it easy, guys.